I stayed in Miami for a minute and made some wonderful connections out here. First and foremost, with a young, beautiful, talented young lady producer by the name of Toya Beats, who me and her have collaborated with for a number of years now on a number of records.
Toya motherfucking Beats, Miami Days on 305 from the Yayo to the Yay, man. This is a beautiful East-West connection. It's been going strong for too long. Now you're
going to
get a witness
of
here.
My name is Toya B. Most people call me Toya. I've been producing for approximately, I would say, 8 years. Been in the music game for a little while. I'm starting now to progress more and more with everything that I do musically. We actually connected through social media. I don't remember if it was Twitter or Instagram or Facebook. Whichever one it was, he was looking for beats, so at that time, I think I had made quite a amount of beats, so I decided to send him some, and he liked it. The particular track that was produced for the WYP, I forgot what the original name was for it anyway. And so the first question he asked me was like, oh, how much you want for it? I was like, damn, like really? Like you didn't say or critique the beat or like, oh yeah, I like that. It was just, how much do you want for it? And so we discussed that, exchanged digits and everything like that, and the rest was history.
I dab in a lot for the reggae music, you feel me? Obviously, the culture is a lot more prevalent out here than it is on the West Coast, and I can connect with artists such as J.B., who's on this record with us, you know what I'm saying, than I can on the West Coast.
Well, you know, I got a message on, actually on Instagram from Diego, and he was like, yo, I got your information from Tonesy, which is a man. Big up yourself, brother. You know, I went to high school with Tone, you know what I mean? We still friends up till this day. He's, you know, he's a very talented artist himself. You know, and he made a connection, and now, you feel me? We here working on this project with me and Diego.
Like shots. Losses. Shots. Losses.
Piggybacking from when we did the WYP, which was like, I don't even remember what year we did that. But, you know, we always stayed in contact. So when he was telling me, you know, he needed some Mo-Fi, as he called them, my beat slappers, you know, I already know the type of style he's looking for.
Let me introduce you to my ghostwriter. What's up? You feel me? I ain't got one. So, yeah, I write all my shit. When you hear me on a record, I'm the one that's done it. I did it from top to bottom, the chorus, the melodies, my verses, you know what I'm saying? And obviously, I take pride in that.
So, Tony got the motive? Don't fuck up. Don't fuck up.
In today's generation, where a lot of people have other individuals and folks writing for them, you know, I'm not the one that's in that category. So for me to be able to do that and connect with the right artist to translate what I'm trying to convey is wonderful. It's beautiful. You know what I'm saying? And man, I'm really happy that I'm able to get a chance to document it with you guys and show everybody the creativity and how deep it really runs, you feel me, and everything that I'm doing on a record.
Feel free to just keep going, even if you need to pick back up. You know what I'm saying? Because we're going to loop the majority of this anyway, so we only need like a certain time frame pocket of it. It's not like I need you to serenade the whole song. You see what I'm saying? we just need to get like a certain segment of it. Like how long, how many bars do you think?
Probably like eight.
I mean, we only need like 8 bars of perfection. You know what I'm saying? So even if you do like a take like you did, well, I'm just going to leave it running and you just pick back up when you're feeling it. Oh, you can?
And like the chorus is really what a lot of people say is the main part of a song because it carries it, you feel me? And know that I did that, you feel me? I wrote that, I harmonized it, I sung it, any which way in between you can think of, whether it's the R&B, the reggae, the rap, you know, and I take pride in that. And like I said, that's just an extension of me as an artist, of me trying to translate everything else that I represent and who I am. And the beautiful thing about JB is that he's right in the middle as far as the perfect balance of having that reggae island feel, you know, just the right accent. But I think he's been in the States long enough where obviously he's been acclimated to American culture, you feel me? So he brings best of the both of those worlds together, you know what I mean? And so for the record, all that is infused in there, right? So it's not too far left on the island, but it's not too far American either, you know what I mean? And it's just the right cadence of energy from Jamaica in the reggae field. Yeah, just shake it on my paper. Blood money, we no care about paper. In a jail, I'm gonna live by your cars. Girls come to Jamaica. In a my crib, grandma got them elevators. Straight class from my feet like a cartel. Don't represent the guys, I'm an asshole. And blessings to him and his camp. They did a stand-up job, and I can't wait to share the record with the world. Westside in this motherfucker till my casket drop.